Guys, this is Dr. Mobeen. Today I'm very excited. I had ordered a Blackmagic Design Intensity Pro HDMI card, and that card is right now in front of me. Ordered it via Amazon, could not wait for it, so ordered for next day shipping, gotten it. Now I'm going to unbox it and put it in the computer, and I would share the experience with you. Alright, the box is open. As you can see, this is how it is. It arrived. So here is the beautiful box, Intensity Pro, HDMI and analog HDSD editing. So let me open this box now. I'll be back. So there you go. Gotten the CD, the card is out. This is a bunch of cables which have arrived with the card. So I believe this is composite. And then these are various, I think, analog. And that is about it. That is what was in the box. There were two compartments in the box. And so, the cables are here and the card is here. Now let me open up the card and open my computer and plug it in. I will once again report to you in a few seconds. Alrighty, so now the card is open. As you can see, here is the card and it has these ports on it. So I believe these are HDMI in, out, and an analog out. Again, I have to yet read this and see what it is, but anyway, so this is the Blackmagic Intensity Pro HDMI and analog HDSD editing card. So now I'm going to install that in the computer and we shall see what happens. Alright, so now my machine is open and I am hoping that the card can go into the slot here. So I'm going to be installing the card here and momentarily. Alright, so the card is in. We shall see what happens. So time to open up the documents. So documents are these. Here is one. So this is the welcome booklet or leaflet. And here is the CD which came with it. So now is the time to close the computer and try to install the card. Okay. So now Windows tried to install the card, could not. And so it says download and install the driver for your video card. But I'm going to now use a CD which came with it to install the product. So of course now here are the contents of the folder. Somehow the auto run this did not work, so I think I need to look at this about this software CD and then run it. So here is the PDF which came with it. So it says that installing Blackmagic software, double click the installer file for the product you're installing and follow the instructions that appear. So I guess I need to figure out what am I installing, and then I'm going to be double clicking that setup file there. So the first thing which I want to do is I'm going to install the ATEM switcher, and the reason for that is that I'm trying to be, my need is to be able to record my videos while I am receiving the input from the camera and maybe also from the video on the desktop, or in the least easy way, I would need to have the video coming in and then switch between various applications on the desktop. So I'm going to install it just to see what it does. So here is the installation. The only interesting thing is that the install product is a slightly slower product than other products I've seen. Here is my security message, and hopefully the installation starts. But anyway, so the installation has started. So of course Windows security message comes up saying, do you really want to install this software? I am going to say yes, install. I have also checked that trust the publisher, and we'll go from there. So the Windows needed to be restarted after the ATEM install. Now I'm going to install something which I think is the right product, and that is desktop video. So I'm going to be installing this driver. So as you can see, I have so far installed ATEM switcher and the desktop video. The disk speed test and ultrascope was just added by itself. So far so good. So of course no media is attached so far. So the window is coming up empty. I'm going to attach a media and then see what happens. Okay. So I had to bring in an SSD and I had to bring in a new graphic card, which cost me, SSD is about $190 and the graphic card is similar price, and that is what was needed to get the Blackmagic card going. So I'm gonna do a quick speed test for the SSD, which is here. So look at that speed test. So write is all the way up to 204, and look at the possibilities. It's almost everything is good. It was dropping frames before, so good news that SSD is working. And here is a final good news. As you can see here, I have actually attached the camera to the Blackmagic, and previously I was not able to see the view here, the preview here, and the reason for that, as I called in the support, they told me that my graphic card was not powerful enough. So went to Best Buy, got a $170 graphic card. Maybe a smaller graphic card would have been able to do the job as well. Anyways, for my purposes, I needed a powerful card anyways for editing and other purposes, so I got the card, and now I can see the preview in there. So very good. So Blackmagic card is working, and now I got a new graphic card thanks to the Blackmagic card, plus I've gotten a new SSD drive in my machine. So that is how it is going. I would let you guys know as I use this product for video recordings. Bye.